This is Crypto Jargon with myself, OJ Jordan. In today's episode, what is an ADI? Also, why are crypto wallet, public key and private key explained? This episode is sponsored by Ledger, the maker of the best hardware wallets on the market. Their devices support more than 1,000 different crypto assets, so you can safely store all of your tokens and coins in a robust cold storage and truly be the owner of your private keys and have the best protection against hackers. To find out more about it, check out the description of the video where you will find the link and my tutorials on the Ledger Nano S and Ledger Nano X devices. Let's start with ADI. First of all, today's terms are all interlinked, hence why I have bundled them together here in this episode. If you've seen the other episodes from this series, you've probably heard me use ADI or wallet address more than a few times. Well, ADI is in fact short for wallet address. For example, send me your ADI and I will wire you the amount, meaning give me your crypto wallet address and I will send you the money. So wire, in this respect, refers to online transacting, sending money digitally. Which leads me to what is a wallet and why address? You see, in crypto, we use digital wallets to store our coins. Well, figuratively speaking, actually, because technically we don't store the coins there, but more about that in a moment. So, figuratively speaking, we use digital wallets in the same way we use physical wallets for the fiat money that we still use in the physical world. Many people call this real money, but I'm sure during the next few years, it will become clear that our digital coins are just as real as the paper money that we still use today. So a digital wallet is basically a piece of software that helps read information about the user's digital coins. In order to send and receive coins, you need to use a long string of alphanumeric characters, usually 26 to 35, which is known as your wallet address. It can also be represented as a scannable QR code. I explained QR code in a previous episode of the Crypto Jargon. It is linked here. There are a few types of cryptocurrency wallets. Software wallets, which are apps and programs. You download this on a desktop or laptop computer. You also have mobile wallets. These are applications on your smartphone or tablet. Web wallets, which are stored on third-party servers via cloud computing. These can be accessed at any time by any computing device, and they're also known as hot storage or hot wallets. You also have paper wallets known as cold storage. Yes, you heard that right. You can even generate a digital wallet that can be printed out as a hard copy for safekeeping in a physical form. I have a tutorial about that too. Check out the pop-up here, and I will also drop the link in the description box so you can see how this works. There's also hardware wallets. They're also known as cold storage, and it's devices like these two here that can store the private keys of the user and access all the information related to these private keys on the relevant blockchains. So let's explain what private and public keys are, just so that you can get the full picture. I will refer to Bitcoin as an example since it is the most popular crypto. I mentioned earlier that you don't actually store your coins in the wallet. So where do you store them then? Technically, you don't store them. Or maybe I should say that store is not the most correct term to use, because your coins exist only as the sum of inputs and outputs, which are recorded on the blockchain as a series of linked transactions. So technically, your coins are simply digital data recorded and stored on the blockchain. They're not inside any wallet. What you actually do when you use your wallet client is that you access that data with your private and public keys. A private key is a unique identifier code used as a digital signature that connects you, the user, to the data stored on the blockchain. In other words, the amount of cryptocurrency that is allocated to that code. It acts as a wallet identifier and is the most important piece of code you need. So it has to be kept in complete secrecy. Anyone who has access to that private key technically has access to the data or the coins that it protects. A public key is derived from that private key, and it is in fact the wallet address you provide to others in order to receive cryptocurrency. The public key is a way to identify someone making a transaction, even though their actual name or personal information is not embedded in that key itself. This is basically your ADI. Also, note that for your own protection, depending on the wallet client that you use, that wallet address might change after every transaction. This should not worry you, because these public wallet addresses are derived from your private key, so all of them will always work. I have a video explaining that too. Link will be dropped in the description box below. Okay, so to wrap this up, your crypto wallet consists of two main pieces of code, known as private and public keys. These are connecting you to the blockchain, where the information about your digital coins is recorded, and this is how you store your cryptocurrencies. This is why it is very important to use wallets that give you full ownership of your private keys. The most secure wallets are paper and hardware wallets, because they give you ownership of these private keys, while most of the cloud services, aka hot wallets, are the custodians of your private keys and they can censor you or lock you out of your wallet. These are services like Coinbase, for instance, and pretty much all of the exchanges, which are government regulated and must comply with anti-money laundering requirements. They're known to freeze or close users' accounts if there's any suspicious activity. Also, they can get hacked, and that happens a lot in the online space. So really, to keep your cryptocurrencies safe in the long run, I recommend using hardware wallets. I hope this is helpful, and this is all for today's episode. Click on that like button for my new viewers, hit the subscribe as well, and don't forget to turn on the notifications so you don't miss an episode. There's many more to come, so watch this space. Enjoying this content? Why not grab a copy of my book Crypto Jargon A to Z, the most thorough dictionary that exists to date, with over 700 definitions of acronyms, trading slang, and all the crypto terminology you need. Just go to ojjordan.com/cryptojargon and grab your digital copy today.
And one more thing.
Announcing my special summer giveaway. Yes, to celebrate the arrival of summer, I'm doing a special summer giveaway on my YouTube channel for all of my subscribers. I'd like to get to know you better, and I want your feedback on my content. In return, I'm giving away not one, not two, but 10 great prizes. 5 physical Revolut debit cards. Revolut is an online bank with zero fee conversion of all major currencies, including Bitcoin and Ethereum, and it's my favorite card to use on my travels. Also, I'm giving away crypto prizes, $50 worth of Bitcoin, $50 worth of Ethereum, $25 worth of Litecoin, and $25 in Dash. And the grand prize, my favorite hardware wallet device, the Ledger Nano S. Compact, secure, and anonymous, the Ledger Nano S is everything you need to store safely your long-term crypto holdings. For your chance to win, all you have to do is like and comment on my videos from now until August, when I will select the winners. You also have to be a subscriber, of course, but it's free to subscribe, so this is your chance to win these fantastic prizes. You are in charge with your luck. The most active subscribers will be rewarded. It's that easy, so get busy.